the record, what's your name, title, and where do you work?
My name is Christine Kahn, Dr. Christine Kahn. I work for the DNR's Office, Department of Natural Resources, Office for a Sustainable Future. I am the Director of Strategic Land Planning. So I do a lot of work with green print mapping. I do a lot of work evaluating ecosystem services. We do a lot of work trying to integrate some of these concepts with local government comprehensive plans.
Okay.
So that's one of the reasons I'm here today.
On that issue, you know, Charles County has had a reputation for not doing the best job as far as conserving land. And now we have this opportunity with this next comprehensive plan update to sort of figure out, you know, if we're really going to embrace smart growth and maybe try to preserve some of our, you know, sensitive environmental areas.
Okay.
I mean, do you think that's, do you think there's a possibility that that's going to happen in this county?
Well, I do. I think that there's enough constituents, citizens in the county who care about the resources, who care what's going to happen. There's a wide body of support within DNR that are concerned about what's happening in Charles County and want to be able to provide the county with the information it needs to make the choices it needs to make. We know that growth is going to happen. We know that the county is very focused on preservation, and we'd like to be able to provide the assistance to make sure that the county and its citizens have all that information in hand so that they know when they make a decision, these are what the environmental, social, and economic costs are going to be.
On another issue, are you at all familiar with the different areas where we have water access, or you're not really?
I got a little bit of that information today.
Okay.
Some of our panelists. So, you know, I'm somewhat aware of the various waterfront.
You know, I think there's a sense by
issues.
Some people that there isn't enough water access. But one of the issues that I thought I didn't really hear was that, you know, trying to go in and develop a sensitive waterfront area becomes a lot more sticky legally because of the critical area laws and all the federal laws that are in place.
Right.
I mean, what can Charles County do with some of its waterfront areas? I mean, what kind of tourism can they actually bring in without actually having to build strip malls and build homes and stuff like that? Do you have any experience with it?
But I don't think that's waterfront development.
Okay.
Having strip malls and you know, housing along the waterfront, to me, is not what waterfront development is. Waterfront development can be a place where people come to gather. They have access to the water. Perhaps there's some marina activities, some small-scale shopping, restaurants, and ideally, relative proximity to some of our other natural resource networks. So if we're looking at waterfront development, first of all, you've got to meet all the environmental regulations. So you can't get around that. They're in place for a reason. You know, and we'd like to see it not happen in an area that's going to be vulnerable to flooding or coastal hazards or sea level rise. You've got to, you know, make sure you're doing it in the right place in the right way. But then there's a lot of opportunity to bring people to these places. Maybe the state owns some land nearby.
Okay.
And we can look at how we bring and connect people to nature by virtue of this gathering place and then access to water trails, waterfront, hiking trails, state parks.
What you're talking about
parks.
Is what you're talking about is low impact type of activity.
Absolutely. I wouldn't personally you know, endorse a huge waterfront development community in a sensitive area.
So we're not talking like National Harbor, you know.
No, and I don't think that Charles County is either.
Okay,
a National Harbor.
Anyway,
you need a lot of port activity to have a National Harbor.
Exactly. Okay, now Charles County is number 4 on some sort of list that you've created.
On our green print map, if you go to our Maryland Green Print website, we've done an analysis. It's online. Just search under Smart Green and Growing. You'll find the Maryland Green Print map. And we've done an analysis of the ecological value of all the lands and waters in the state, and we've identified significant areas. We call these targeted ecological areas, and those are areas where they have just exceptional statewide value. Within Charles County, over 56% of the land has been identified as a green print targeted ecological area. There's only 3 other counties above that: Garrett, Somerset, and Dorchester, maybe. It was two other Eastern Shore counties. So can you Charles County ranks four in the
so
state.
So we shouldn't pave it over, though.
Significance.
Should we?
No.
Okay, don't pave it over.
Can
you give us?
Well, we look at a couple different issues. We look at green infrastructure, and that's this idea of large hubs connected to each other by corridors. So it's a fragmentation issue. There's a lot of green infrastructure left in Charles County. We also look at forests that are important for water quality because we believe that retaining forests is good for the bay. They're providing a water quality service. So those there are some very important forest lands just for that service in Charles County. We look at aquatic biodiversity hotspots. These are watersheds that have very unique aquatic biology. So we're looking at unique assemblages of fish and macrobenthic invertebrates, like the mayflies and that sort of thing. And then we also look at rare, threatened, and endangered species habitat through our Wildlife and Heritage Program. And there's a large number of RT&E species that occur within Charles County. So you could say it is an ecological gem across the state.
But it's threatened, though.
As you well know, there's planning and development districts that are going to impact some of those resources. So,
unless we change. I mean, we can change our comprehensive plan. And
the comprehensive plan should, we hope that it will reflect the protection of these significant resources. And the Mattawoman Creek is one of those resources.
Dr. Khan, do you think there is a way of striking a balance between growth and development and an economic engine with preserving these natural resources and what makes this county so unique?
Well, I do, and I think there's a couple different ways that we can look at that. And ecotourism and agrotourism, I think, are key. People come to Charles County to live here and also to recreate here. So there's a lot of opportunity to keep that engine going. There's also a lot of opportunity to use these natural resources to provide the services that the county citizens and the bay need. So one area that I'm really interested in pursuing is that these resources can help create resilience to climate change. Okay, we're going to get a lot of water. And if you don't have the natural resources such as the forests, forested floodplains, wetlands to help mitigate all that extreme weather, then we're going to turn around and we're going to end up having a really hefty price tag to repair all those damages that these floods and extreme weather events are causing. So, there's a strategy there for resilience. Well, those are some of the areas. Of course, there's the fisheries issue in the Mattawoman. If you lose that, I think it's, a $40 million industry just for the bass tournament. It's a tremendous economic impact, so...